Hello guys, in our project we created our dataset class, image to matrix class and algorithm class, and now we are going to create its main class or face recognition class, which is its final class and which class binds all class. So I'm going to name it face recognition. Okay, so let's bring it here, and now I'm going to import CV2 class and import from algo class import my algo, and from image to matrix class import image to matrix class, and from dataset import dataset class. Okay, so in dataset we chosen oral. So now we are going to create a variable recognition type, and now I am naming it as image because later we are going to work on like video or group image. So recognition type image, another variable number of images of one person, means how much at least images of one person should be for training. It's for 8 because we are going that to dataset later as a required number. So now dataset object will be equals to dataset class, and we are going to pass our argument number of images of one person. Now we are going to create another all variables images paths for training equals to dataset object dot images path for training, and labels for training equals to dataset object dot labels for training, and similarly number of elements for training equals to dataset object number of elements for training, number of images for training, it's same thing, and same thing for testing. Testing we are going to change variables names, image paths for testing, labels name for testing, and number of images for testing. Okay, now we are going to import target names or image targets. Image targets equals to dataset object dot image target. Okay, now we imported all. Now we are going to create two more variable. One is image width, which will be our width of matrix, and image height, both 50-50 because I am working on 50-50. Okay, now image to matrix class your image to matrix class object will be image to matrix class, and we are going to give input for image to matrix class image paths, image width and image height. So image paths for training, image width and image height, and it will return us image matrix. So image matrix will be image to matrix class object dot get matrix. It will give us matrix. Now work starts from our algo class. My algo class object will be my algo, which we imported here, and we are going to pass its argument. First is image matrix. Okay, then image labels. Image labels for training. Okay, labels for training. And third is target names, image targets. And fourth is number of elements for training. Fifth is image width. And sixth is image height. And now is quality percent, which we are going giving 90%. Okay, so this is our algo class. So it will give us new coordinates equals to my algo class object dot reduce dimension. So now we received our new coordinates. Now is process for recognition process. In this, let's make it more space for it more clear. First we are going to check recognition type. If recognition type is what is recognition type, image, then do this. Create three variables, correct images equals to 0, wrong is 0, and one or more variable I equals to 0. Now we are going to start our loop for image path in images paths for train testing. Now we are testing our algorithm. First we are going to create image using our algorithm class, my algo class dot image from path, image path. It will give us image, and this is our image path. Now we are going to show this image and showing label recognize this image, and we are going to pass this image, and we are going to find new coordinates for this image because we are going to recognize this image equals to my algo class dot new codes, and for this image. Now we are going to find its name using our algo class. Find name equals to my algo class object dot recognize this face and new coordinates for this image. And we already know its original name. Its original name is, first we have to find what is index of our original image. So target index equals to labels for testing and image number, which is I, and that will be our name, original name, equals to target names, and we are going to pass this target index. So this will be its original name. And if find name, let's change it to find it name is original name, then we are going to increase correct, and we are going to print correct value, correct result, and we are also going to print its name. Name will be find it name, or we are going to print this, and else if not equals to original name, then wrong plus equals to I one, and print wrong result and name this, and we are going to increment I at each loop. And after ending loop, we are going to print total correct equals to correct, total wrong wrong. Let's create more space. Print percentage will be correct divided by correct plus wrong add into 100. This will be percentage. Now our code is ready, so we have to run this. Right click here and run face recognition. So let's see what happens. So we showed image here, recognize image, so I think it will be going to show. So it's saying recognize this image, and when we click any button on keyboard, it shows this correct result name P1, and now it's recognizing this image, and we click, it shows its correct name, and then it is P10. So like this it shows for all images, and let's keep pressing so it will go fast. And there are also some wrong results here, you can see P35, but some of images are also not very good, very distorted. So let's keep pressing to go for all tests. So after completing our whole test data set, it found that total correct images are 73, total wrong are 3, and percentage accuracy is 96.05, which is better than PCA. So you can also improve more accuracy using by improving our images using superposition. So that's it means our algorithm is working. So now let's take another look on our class. So first we tell what kind of recognition we want. We want recognition of type image. Then we tell how many images of single person for training. Then we tell that to our dataset class. Then we imported all the variables from our data class, like for training, images, paths, labels and number of elements. And for testing, images, paths, labels and number of elements. And images, targets for our labels. And then we provided images width and height, means our matrix size, to our image to matrix class, which we created a matrix and returned as image matrix from getMatrix method. Then we go to our algorithm class and ask for reduced dimensions. And after reducing dimensions, it provided new coordinates which we can use. And after that, our recognition process started. In recognition process, we created if checked if recognition type is image, and we created three variables, correct 0, wrong 0, and I equals to 0. And we created a loop on our images path for testing. And we redid one image from our function image from path from our algorithm class. We then displayed using our show image function from our algorithm class, means recognize this image. Then we get new coordinates from our algorithm class, and then we asked for recognize this face using our algorithm class, which told us name of that image which our algorithm thinks, but we know its name, original name, which we can find using our target index. And we checked if name is equals to original name, if this correct equals to +1 and correct results and name of that correct result, otherwise it is wrong. And we also incremented 1, and at last we printed all things like total correct, total wrong and percentage. So that's all for this video. In next video I'm going to show how can you recognize face in video or group image. So thank you for watching, like this video and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.